In this video, we'll look at how you can rebuild sequences or timelines that you want to import from other nonlinear editing applications. To set a context around this, depending on how you like to work, you might want to edit in your other NLE and complete your program in Autodesk Smoke. If this is the case, then keep watching and I'll show you how to use the conforming tools to import your sequences. Whether you're working with Apple Final Cut Pro 7 or Apple Final Cut Pro 10, first you need to export an XML. If you're using Avid Media Composer or Adobe Premiere Pro, you need to export an AAF. Smoke supports both these formats and is able to rebuild your sequences from the other editing application. With regards to media such as video sources, you may choose to work with the native media or recompressed intermediates coming from your other NLE. For example, you could have edited using Apple ProRes and now you want to edit with native R3D files. Or perhaps you consolidated and transcoded your original media to DNX HD and you want the choice to either use your original media or the DNX HD intermediates. The conforming tools in Smoke will give you all these choices when conforming your sequence. I will be touching on a few different scenarios as the steps will change depending if you're on one system, using many systems, and physically moving media around. The first scenario is pretty straightforward. You have been working in your NLE and you simply export an AAF or XML. You've imported media from various locations from your drives and your network, but none of the media has been moved around. So this would be a typical job where everything is done on one workstation. In Smoke, you start off by switching to the Conform tab. This interface will display your sequence at the bottom of the screen, and it will also display an event list of every single clip used in the active sequence. To begin the process of importing your AAF or XML, go to the media library and choose a folder that you want your sequence to be located as it is imported. If you do not select a folder in the media library, the import XML and AAF option will be grayed out. You can always move the sequence clip to another folder at a later time if desired. Now at the bottom of the event list, click on the gear menu and you can choose to load a new XML or AAF file. In the browser, you can navigate to the folder location where you exported your AAF or XML. In my case, I exported the sequence to the desktop. Double-clicking on the XML file will bring up the preview player with relevant clip information, such as format, resolution, and frame rate. Just as a side note, when importing media into Smoke, you can choose to work with the native media or tell Smoke to create its own transcoded versions. This step also applies to the conform process, where you can choose how your footage is managed as Smoke rebuilds your sequence. Just switch to the General tab, and if Create Project Media is disabled, Smoke will work with the native media. If you enable this option, Smoke will transcode the imported media for the sequence for optimized performance. In this case, I want to work with the native media, so I'll ensure the option is turned off. Now switch to the Sequence Import Options tab. In this scenario, there are only two settings I want to bring your attention to: Relative Search Options and Media Options. When you import the XML or AAF, Smoke searches for files in two ways. The first way is looking inside the XML or AAF. These formats normally store the absolute location of the media file on your system. The second way is to get Smoke to look in other folders and subfolders close to the AAF or XML location. The second method is useful for specific scenarios, but in most cases, if the media has not been moved around, the absolute file locations embedded in the XML or AAF should be fine to find all the media. Just note that Smoke will always first look in the XML or AAF for the original file location before searching other folders in the relative search. In this scenario, our media has not been moved around, so I will turn off Search and Import Files. The relative search has been disabled, and the only option you really need to look at is the media options. The link to media files will connect the media files at their original location, and you can choose to consolidate your head and tail frames on import. The preferred media option is more specific to Avid editing software. Using original sources connects the AAF to the original files. Using the offline intermediates connects the AAF to the transcoded DNX HD files from the Avid editing software. Once your settings are ready, you can start the conform process and Smoke will rebuild the sequence and start looking for the media. You can monitor this process at the bottom left of the screen. Once this process is complete, you will see the sequence clip in the media library folder, and there will also be a subfolder with all the sources used in the conform sequence. The event list will also populate itself with all the entries from the open sequence. You will notice that the status of each clip says linked, and when you click on each entry, the positioner in the sequence will jump to that particular segment matching its source's entry. So you can verify each source has been found and the conform has been successful. Now you can switch to the Timeline tab and begin your work in Smoke. Please consult the Autodesk Online Wiki for the list of supported effects coming from AAF and XML sequences. In the next video, we'll look at a different scenario where the media has been moved around and you can use the conform tools in Smoke to seek out and connect to your media files.